side of the bed. What's up with this Prince song inside my head? Hands up if you're down to get down tonight, 'cause it's always a good time. Slept in all my clothes like I didn't care. Hopped into a cab, take me anywhere. I'm in if you're down to get down tonight. It's always a good time.
Good morning and good night. I wake up at twilight.
It's gonna be alright. We don't even have to try. It's always a good time.
Whoa,
it's always a good time.
Whoa.
Good morning, Falcons, and welcome back to our second online show.
Although it's unfortunate that we can't be back in the studio, we're happy to be here today to give you the Talon Morning News from a comfort of our own homes.
We are so excited for today's episode. We will see a story about virtual college tours and pets during the pandemic.
Get ready, CB. Today's episode starts now.
All sophomore, junior, and senior students with a 3.0 or higher, listen up. CB's National Honor Society is looking for this year's fabulous applicants. If you are involved in leadership roles, service activities, and community service, then please take the time to fill out an application found on Schoology. Take a chance and brag about yourself. We want to hear all about you. Please remember, though, if you have already been accepted last year, then there is no need to apply again. All applications are due by Tuesday, February 16th to Ms. Malarkey. Class of 2021, faculty and staff are working hard to make this final semester of your senior year a special one. Approximately each month, we will have one activity or event planned for the class of 2021 to enjoy. The first event will allow you to experience Mini Kai as Mr. Havey virtually leads you through mapping my life's journey on the evening of February 22nd from 6 to 8 p.m. Get to know your fellow classmates, teachers, and staff in small groups. Dinner will be provided and delivered to you. See the Schoology bulletin to register. Registration is free, but it closes at 11:59 p.m. on Saturday, February 14th. The SAT exam for CB juniors and seniors is currently scheduled for Wednesday, March 3rd from 8 to 1 p.m. at Christian Brothers High School. Only juniors and seniors will be on campus for this day, and students will remain with their cohorts when assigned classrooms. Cohort C students must be able to test on campus. Juniors who have not yet received your college handbook. If you are in cohort A or B and once you are back on campus, please come to the counseling office in the main hallway to pick it up. Cohort C students, your handbook will be mailed home. In counseling news, seniors, complete the mid-year transcript request form found in the college updates for class of 2021 Schoology page and the class of 2021 Teams group under files for your first semester transcript to be sent to your colleges. Additionally, seniors, please continue to update family connections with your admissions results and send the counselors any school-based or private scholarship awards you received so they can be included in our graduation program. Hey CB, Student Activities wants to inform you that we will be having our Valentine's Spirit Day on February 16th and 18th. Stay tuned for more information and a dress code. As we all know, the COVID-19 pandemic has had a grand effect on all of our lives. For juniors, the time to start looking at colleges has already begun. With campuses being closed due to the virus, many people are unable to take in-person tours. With this said, KBFT's very own Grace Cowan and Emily Duncan bring you a story about virtual college tours during this unprecedented time. Let's see what they have to say.
Many students have started looking at colleges, but during these uncertain times, how can you go to look at a college? I toured UCLA and Ave Maria University to see the differences between visiting a college in California versus one out of state. UCLA is currently only offering online tours that you can sign up for and get a link in your email. The tour is still able to show you all that you would see if you were at a tour on the campus. And we are still able to ask all of our questions and get answers through the chat. According to UCLA student Emily, who majors in political science, the university is not generally open to the public. Select buildings on campus are in use to support the essential activities of remote learning and continuity of research. Recommended infection control procedures will be in place on campus once students return to in-person classes, including physical distancing, disinfecting classrooms and other spaces, frequent cleaning of classrooms and facilities, and requiring face coverings while on campus, consistent with guidance from Los Angeles County Department of Public Health. Daily symptom checks will be required for everyone coming to campus or living in campus housing. Testing and contact tracing protocols for COVID-19 will also be in place. While most colleges in California can only be toured online, we also went to Ave Maria University in Florida and spoke with Mary Dufresne, an admissions counselor at the college, to find out how they were handling campus tours during COVID.
So personally, I've been really impressed with the way that Ave Maria has taken care of things with COVID. From the beginning, with all the shutdown, we decided to start doing digital Ave experiences. So once a month, or sometimes twice a month, we'll have a virtual tour in which you get to hear professors speak, and you'll get to talk to admissions counselors live, you hear from the president, and you get to see the whole tour of campus as if you were here in person. And we even give a small grant to students that participate in that. But we've also maintained staying open in order that students can come visit in person if they're not too concerned. So maintaining social distance, doing a lot of sanitation, and then mask wearing throughout the whole process. But we always want to keep that as an open option for any student who would want to. But for the most part, we don't go into a lot of the buildings. Right now, since there's no students on campus, we're able to go into more buildings. But when there's students here, we typically just stay outside.
This has been Grace Cowan reporting for the Talon Morning News.
Founders Dylan and Tavia are excited to welcome you to the Collective Minds Club, a club where your mental health matters. We serve to highlight prominent mental health and global issues that are widely stigmatized in today's society. Our mission is to find accessible coping mechanisms with the help of our peers in a non-judgmental space, here at Christian Brothers. In the midst of a pandemic, natural disasters, and the stressors of high school, Collective Minds will provide a safe space for any student who is looking to surround themselves with a supportive club community. Our club emphasizes the importance of meditation, journaling, and music, among others, as important and accessible ways to cope with mental health issues in our current state. We value the importance of candid conversations among peers to build trust in each other and have an outlet to express our emotions. With the help of our moderators, Ms. McDougall and Mr. Hood, we will conduct weekly virtual meetings on Mondays at 1 p.m. We welcome you with open arms to the Collective Minds Club because you don't have to struggle in silence.
Hey CB, it's Mitchell here with some more announcements. Auditions for the play 20th Century are this February 9th. Join the Schoology group 20th Century for news and updates regarding auditions for our spring production of this screwball comedy. Use the code QHGBZ-2BNQH. In the resources file, there's a full script and an audition folder containing the current casting breakdown, audition slides, and the rehearsal schedule. We'll be doing a virtual production, so even if you're at home in Cohort C, you'll still be able to participate. Fill out an audition form and submit it to Mr. Jackson before February 9th. The February Falcon Drop Drive for women and children experiencing homelessness or in life transition, with partnership including Women's Empowerment Bishop Galagos Maternity Home and Wellspring Women's Center, will take place on Saturday, February 13th from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. in front of the school. Items that are requested include baby wipes, baby formula, diapers and pull-ups, gently used or new children's clothing and shoes, new children's underwear and socks, new women's underwear and socks, gently used or new women and children's coats and rain jackets, Valentine's Day candy, and see Schoology for more specific information. Tired of feeling stressed out all the time between school, COVID, and everything in between? Join the Collective Minds Club with Dylan Julia Cooper, Tavia Richardson, Mr. Hood, and Ms. McDougal. They meet every Monday at 1 p.m. to practice methods that are proven to reduce stress and discuss the societal pressures that cause it. If you're interested, email Dylan Julia Cooper at iCloud.com. Hey CB, Regional Transit is now allowing students to ride the bus or light rail for free. All you need to do is have your valid student ID and present it in order to get a free ride. See Schoology for more information. Falcons, do you have a favorite Christmas gift that you would like to show in the yearbook, or do you have any pictures from a vacation that would like to be featured? Well then, if you are interested, submit all pictures to ryanprice466@gmail.com. With the COVID-19 pandemic, many of us have been self-isolating in our homes, resulting in a somewhat depressing state. But the perfect solution to this is the issue of pets in our lives. Pets are known to stimulate and bring up your spirit. Let's go find out information about these with a package brought to you by Brooke Patterson and Taylor Patton.
Quarantine has been difficult for us humans, but quite the opposite remains for our furry friends. Many people have taken to adopting animals to keep their spirits up during quarantine. We spoke to CB student Carmen Lloyd, who got a pet over quarantine, and she shared what some of the benefits have been. First, Carmen tells us how she came to find her cat, Ruby.
Some woman was walking, actually, and was like, your cat is on the side of the house. So my dad's like, we don't own a cat. So he went to the side of the house, and she was just sitting there all by herself.
Carmen tells us what being a first-time cat owner has been like for her.
Having a pet over quarantine has been really fun, but like it's a lot of work because this is me and my parents' first cat, so there's a lot to like learn of having her, but she's cute and fun.
Carmen tells us her favorite part about having a cat.
My favorite part about having my cat is having company and being able to like play with her, and she's just nice to have around.
Carmen then tells us why having a cat has been great, especially during quarantine.
Don't really have that many people with you during quarantine, just like your family and closest friends. So having someone to like rely on is nice during quarantine.
Next, Carmen tells us why having a cat has been stress relieving for her.
Having a cat has been stress relieving because she's like calm, and if you're feeling stressed, you can go play with her to like forget about things that are stressing you out.
Carmen and Ruby's story reflects some of the good that has come out of COVID-19, and the best part is their story is just one of thousands that has taken place. This has been Brooke Patterson and Taylor Payton reporting for the Talon Morning News.
Yeah! Today's show went by so fast, CB. I can't believe it's already over.
Thanks for tuning in, and we can't wait to see you back on campus next week.
Until then, wear your masks and stay 6 feet apart. The set order for today is BFG.
Have a fun and relaxing weekend, CB.